There's good news for Broward County residents. The second most populated county in Florida is ending 2016 on a high note, with a slew of new construction projects, reduced property taxes, and the lowest unemployment rate in the Tri-County area. And the outlook for the new year seems just as bright. And so joining me now to share more about the state of the county, we welcome outgoing Broward County Mayor and County Commissioner and Property Appraiser-elect Marty Kiar. Marty, thanks for taking the time. Again, congrats on the new position. But before we get to that, let's talk about, I guess, maybe some of the highlights and some of the things that you and the commission really have worked so hard to achieve for Broward County. Start wherever you want.
Well, first, thank you so much, Henry, for inviting me on and for the great work that you do keeping South Florida informed. And I have to tell you, Broward County is a wonderful place. There are more people in Broward County than 13 states, the District of Columbia, and all U.S. territories except Puerto Rico. And so to have been able to be the mayor of a place as big of, as a state and to help make a difference for the 1.8 million people that live there was without a doubt the greatest honor I've ever had. And this year, last year, as we come to the end of the year, our outlook, it was wonderful. And where Broward County is moving is also excellent as well. And let me give you a couple examples.
Sure.
You kind of mentioned it in your opening. Broward County's unemployment rate is lower than the national average, lower than the state average, and it's actually lower than almost every than every other big county within the state of Florida.
Is that because actual jobs were created, or did more people drop out of the labor force search as a result?
Broward County had the highest job creation rate out of any county within the state of Florida. We created a significant amount of jobs in the financial service industry, in the construction industry, and one reason is because we have a very pro-business environment. I mean, we inspire businesses to relocate there. A good example is Chiquita Banana. Chiquita Banana was getting taxed very highly in another state, and they were looking to relocate either to here or to New York or elsewhere, and we actually went out there and we got them and we brought them to Port Everglades, and we do that constantly. And that's the type of economic environment that we have in Broward County. And another reason why we do so well is because we have a very robust tourism industry. You know, there's 1.8 million people that live in Broward and 15 million people that visit us every single year. And so we invest very heavily in our economic engines that bring tourism here. Our airport's a great example. This year, about 29 million people will fly in and out of the Fort Lauderdale-Hollywood International Airport. And we try to make it as convenient as possible for them. Our port generates billions of dollars of economic activity every single year, and we invest very heavily in that. We renourish our beaches and just really try to inspire people to want to visit us, which creates a lot of jobs.
So some stats on that then, right? Passengers arriving, departing from Fort Lauderdale-Hollywood up nearly 9%. Passengers going in and out of Port Everglades is almost twice as more at 55,885 cruise passengers, right?
Well, that was actually just one day.
Oh, that's one day.
It is.
Yes, you're right. You're right.
It did. We set a world record on one day, I believe it was in March of last year, where 55,000 people took a cruise ship out of Port Everglades, which is the second busiest multi-day cruise port terminal in the world. I mean, it's a really impressive economic engine that we're very proud of.
Mm-hmm. And so to the job front, too, not only is the unemployment rate down, but also creation up 4.4%, 8,700 jobs in trade, 3,500 jobs in financial, and again, 4.6 unemployment rate, lowest at least within the Tri-County area. And to that, to those stats, you owe what is really the cause of those stats? As you were mentioning, the influx of external businesses, but also tourism and some of the other things.
Absolutely. Well, in Broward County, we're very, very lucky. South Florida's lucky, but Broward County especially. And there's a whole bunch of factors that play a role in that. You know, we have a great relationship between government and also business. We believe in a lot of public-private partnerships. We try to have low taxing. For example, we even reduced property taxes a little bit this year. We have a sales tax that's at 6 cents, which is the lowest in the Tri-County area as well. And we just try to foster an environment where we want people to come here and we want businesses to relocate here. Our school system, our Broward County school system heavily invests in our public schools. I mean, we have the sun, we have the beaches. There are so many factors that play a role in our low unemployment rate and our wonderful business climate.
So with respect to the tax issue, you reduced property taxes by 1%, right?
We did. This year, we decided to roll back the millage rate in Broward County, and we did roll it back by 1%, and the reason being is we realized, you know, property values are rising, and so more money was coming into our county coffers, and we are able to spend a whole lot of money to provide wonderful services to Broward County, and Broward County decided that it wanted to live within its means as well, and we believed that we had money to provide great services, so we decided to roll it back so we could return some of the money to the people.
Okay, how does that really square then now with your new role as property appraiser? And can maybe you talk a little bit about why you wanted to be property appraiser and sort of what it means to you, and again, sort of how, again, you square sort of fiscal solvency and growth with your new position?
That's a great question. I'll tell you, I feel very honored and very excited to be one of our new constitutional officers for Broward County. The property appraiser is elected countywide, so every single person in Broward County is my boss. They're my constituents. And the property appraiser's job, I believe, is one of the most important jobs in all government. And the reason being is because everything starts with the property appraiser. The property appraiser's office determines the assessed value of every single property in the county, whether it's residential or commercial, tangible personal property, and those values are what millages are based on. So our cities and our counties, they based their property taxes based on what the values of the property are in the county. And that's how they find out how much money they're going to have to provide services to the people of our county, to the people of Broward County. Mm-hmm. And what my job is to make sure that our taxpayers are treated fairly. If we overvalue properties, then people will be paying too much in property taxes. That's not fair. If we undervalue properties, that means that folks aren't paying their fair share and not enough money is going into government to provide services such as transportation and parks and libraries and health and human services. Another thing that I'm very excited about is the current property appraiser's office, which is run by my dear friend Lori Parrish, who's retiring, takes a very proactive approach in finding folks who are entitled to homestead exemptions or to senior exemptions or to disability exemptions, and they may not know that they're entitled to this. She goes out, they find it, and people are actually given exemptions that they're entitled to, so their property taxes are actually reduced each year, and I'm going to continue that as well. It's a great job where you can do a lot of good for a lot of folks.
Sure. What are the mechanisms by which you determine property value? You talk about fair share, but who, or is it you, really, that determines what's fair?
Well, what determines is basically the market, and I'll explain this. All property is assessed on January 1st of the taxable year, and it's always 1 year before. And the way that you do it, if you're dealing with residential property, let's say, for example, you decide that you just buy a home, and you want to know what your home is worth. The property appraiser's job is to look in your community, find out, look at your sale of your home, look at all other sales in that area, and then they adjust those sales to make them comparable to your home, and then based on those sales, they determine what the value of your home is, and that's how it goes on, and so the tax notice you get is based on that value. If it's commercial property, you can use the comparable sale method, but you can also look at the income the property generates to determine its value, or you can look at how much it would cost to build that property to determine the value. There's all kinds of ways to do it to be able to come up with the most fair and accurate assessment for the people of our county.
Sure, and highly important too, as you noted before the show, if only because of the revenue that results from obviously property valuing for the sake of the county and the residents themselves. Mm-hmm. Whatever happened, we did a lot of shows on the transportation penny sales tax. Whatever happened with that?
It failed.
Okay.
And there were two ballot questions that were put on the ballot for the people of Broward County to vote for. And both of them had to pass for the sales tax to be increased by 1 cent to 7 cents to pay for transportation. Mm-hmm. And one, the Broward County Commission, and I voted for it to put it on the ballot, voted to put a proposed half cent increase. And that if that would have passed, that money would have gone to mass transit, light rail, and then the cities put on a half cent increase, and that money would have gone to infrastructure projects. Well, what happened was the people of Broward County voted in support more than 50% for the county's proposed half cent increase, but voted against the half cent increase for the cities. And because they both didn't pass, they both failed. And that was the way it was set up. And
So what's plan B?
That I don't know.
You don't have to worry about it anymore.
I'm not on the county commission anymore, so that's for them to decide. But my motto generally is I always think that the voters get it right. And if there's something to put before the voters, I generally vote for it because I want them to tell me if they want this or if they don't want this. Mm-hmm. And I know that our voters put a lot of time and effort and thought into whether or not they wanted to increase the sales tax by a penny. Ultimately, they said no, they didn't like the way it was structured. Mm-hmm. And I think that personally, I believe that government should respect the will of the voters.
Sure, and maybe now in the new year we can figure out a way to address the obvious issue, which is transportation in Broward County.
It is.
Because it's not as if we're not without a problem.
Right. There is a big problem with transportation. And one reason being is, you know, we have 1.8 million people that live here and 15 million people that visit us every single year. That's a lot of folks in a small area. It's more people than in some massive states where they have tons of sprawling land. And we do have a transportation problem. There's only so much money you can throw at light synchronization. There's only so many roads that you can build.
Right.
And so I do hope that the county commission keeps addressing that issue and keep working.
As outgoing commissioner and mayor for Broward County, do you have any regrets?
Do I have any regrets?
Anything that you wish you could have done differently? Any lessons learned, teachable moments, that sort of stuff?
Sure. Well, you know, no matter what you do, there's always something that you wish you could have pursued a little bit more. And there are so many things that I'm proud of, but I'll tell you a good example, something that, you know, if I could go back in time, I would put even more effort into it than I did. One of the things that I'm so proud of that we've passed is a civil citation program that gives police officers the ability to issue civil citations to students to people that are caught with a misdemeanor amount of marijuana rather than arresting them. That's a very important thing because if you give a civil citation, that's not an arrest, and that gives people the opportunity to have another chance in life.
Yeah.
And that was something that I sponsored that I was very proud of. Some of the cities have adopted it and some of the cities haven't. And what I decided to do was respect the local decisions of some of the cities that didn't want to adopt it and didn't want to pursue it. And so, and to focus primarily on just the ones that did. Weston's a great example. They've been awesome. They've given a number of civil citations that have given another chance in life. If I can go back in time, I think I would try to put a little bit more pressure on some of those cities that haven't adopted it because I believe so strongly in this program. And there are things of that nature that I could go back in time, I would do a little bit differently.
Got you. Well, congrats again on the new position and congrats on all the successes as commissioner and mayor. So thanks for taking the time, Marty.
Oh, thank you, Henry. And thank you again for all the great work you do.
Thank you.
You're awesome.